I just had him out for a walk and he did number one.
And he did a big number two when he got here this morning. So he should be in pretty good shape for a pop. Alright.
Okay, what's next?
You guys can go in and sit with him if you'd like.
Okay.
Should we do?
Oh, shoot, the fourth, isn't it?
Can we do what? There's.
Alright, so I'm gonna get you guys started with the first parts.
So.
Let's start with page one, how's that?
Okay.
This one has two sides to it.
Okay.
And then.
Can you show them then?
Yeah. I'll close up this now. Makes things so much easier. So he's actually had two names during the time that he's been at PACC, where he was his most recent one. And he was previously.
Do you have the sign out Friday or are you working on it?
I'm working.
Okay. Just put this on your wall. Yeah, it's in my way, it's only reason.
So you can really change the lines.
I'm gonna have to move it.
His original name, the first, the last time he came through was Cobain, like, first, I guess. So, probably I don't know that Ricky is all that much better, but.
You know, when I had him on the walk, I was saying his name and he kept looking at me.
Well, he was with that guy for a little while, I don't know how long, but.
Alright. So, that was really interesting. Make something?
Squirrels.
Can you make a reindeer or something with it from you?
No.
Snow yet?
But you know, like, they would.
A 5-foot star.
Okay, let's do that with it.
Is that enough?
Okay, let's do that.
This one's not a big girl.
5-foot star, yeah.
Girl, it's a.
I know.
I think you can do it.
I don't think you can.
I don't care.
I think this is a beautiful thing.
I think you guys just can pass it by, right?
No. It's just some banter, you know?
Uh-huh.
Keep it fun and fresh and. Everything.
Cause we wanna do this.
See, this is how I know it went between you guys, exactly, cause I have memories of this.
And it was that other girl too.
There was that, yeah, I don't know, I never did know her name.
I think it was Amanda?
Juan?
No, I don't care. Oh, it was.
It was Amanda.
Yeah.
I don't think she came back. Because she got on the ladder.
That's why I asked.
Maybe that's why she didn't come back.
You made her climb up all out. Jesse, you gotta stop it, girlfriend.
Jesse. Where's the shy hat? Jesse's girl. What's the matter, sweetie?
You have a little more to your head.
What's the matter?
That's not bad right there.
Are you okay?
Yeah, that's good.
You can't be barking like that. It's because you want attention.
Hey, tape lady, you're talking on your job.
Trying to console Jesse.
I know, I'm sorry, sweetheart.
Jesse, it's okay, honey.
Not that big of a.
Oh my goodness. Jesse.
So he came in here and didn't have any obvious, like, any health stuff, so they haven't seen him in a clinic since he's been here. Cause they don't take him into a clinic unless there's something where there's a cause for concern. And since he's been through PACC before, he's already been neutered, he's already microchipped. He did get a shot when he came in, so that's all done. So I'm gonna send him home with the stuff that we have on him. I have no room for anything.
like to. And then, like, what was it, 2:40? 2:40 until 3:10. I'm like, I looked up at 1:40.
You forgot how to make the 5 points
an hour? No. I'm doing it. I'm trying to figure out names.
It's a good problem, but.
Gosh. I don't need your shoes sitting right now. Should I go a little bit closer?
Okay,
yeah.
I've got three piles going.
Is that keep them on?
All right, so this is this one. Yeah. Just like the back two. Okay. This is the adoption agreement, so you read through your initial and then put your information. And we'll go, and I'll leave the copies of all of this stuff here.
What are you getting all whipped up about?
Huh?
You're fine. Knock it off.
Who was it, Rookie?
Yeah. He's reactive to them inside the kennel. He's been like that.
And then he's out and he's free.
It's okay. Really. So sweet. Aren't ya? Oh, that's gonna look good.
You can just bounce back and forth. Did you have any questions on the adoption group?
Oh, look at you.
Oh, look at that.
It's all Ellie.
Right back and we'll forget.
Ellie, will you come to my house?
A few times where I've been running after the people that have adopted her foster. I'm like, wait, don't leave.
How the heck did you do that?
Thank you.
computer screen pops up with all the tools. I'm like, no, I didn't mean to touch that. So as a volunteer, I made it my personal mission to get that dog
adopted. Oh my goodness.
And he did.
Wow. They know how to pull on heartstrings.
I know. That's actually made back to family.
Oh my goodness.
She's like, you got my dog adopted. I said, it was very clearly explained to you when you dropped him off that you were trending membership. I said, I told you this was a possibility. He said, I feel like this is because of you. I looked at him. I said, yeah, it was. It absolutely was. I'm totally okay with that.
I believe it.
Oh, no, sorry, that's for you. That's just your seat. There's no place to sign. Sorry.
I don't get to see that way.
Look, I'm telling a story. I forgot what I was doing. Okay, so these are just copies of everything we just filled out.
Do you have one more right one?
So on here, it has his animal ID number and his membership number here. We can make a point out in the other place. Just say it on the side if they want to. So this is his medical. So he was at PACC before, but the number that he has now, his animal ID number, this is a new number. So they merged the old file into it, and for some reason, sometimes it drops like previous notes and medical stuff. So it doesn't have when he's new, but he is. Even though it doesn't have it here, it's here. So that's your legal proof. You need more than that PACC to find something, but you should be fine. So this has his animal ID number here. That's the date of birth. Is really all that is from the first time he came here. That was the date he was coming down. So it just automatically, it's whatever their guesstimate is at the time that he comes through. So he was there in 2017. So he must have been adopted as a puppy because he's only 5 years old. Yeah. Or no, I take that back. They aged him at 5 years. That was his intake date this year. So he came in on the 23rd. They aged him at 5, so it automatically was 2 years off. So they're saying that was his birth date. This shows you the shots that he got. We had a canine on the 23rd, which is his rabies, his temporal parvo, and his intranasal bordetella for the kennel cough vaccine, which honestly is about as effective in these dogs as the flu vaccine is. It's a hit or miss every year. Just like the flu vaccine, they guess what they think in different regions of the country are going to be the most common strains of kennel cough in dogs, and they do the vaccine based on that. So, you've got dogs coming and going from different states all the time, and they introduce some germs. So, as far as I'm concerned, it really doesn't trouble heck of a lot. Hence the feeling sign. If he starts to break with kennel cough, it's going to be pretty obvious. They get that cough, and the cough gets deeper and deeper. So, ideally, you would keep him and the other separated. I know that's not really practical. I think this is going to be better than me buying my taxes. Each time I bring him in, I'm like, you know what? So, unless either your other ones have, like, significant health issues where their immune system is compromised, most of the time, even if they get it, they can get it in a couple days by themselves. With him, he appears to be a really healthy dog, so he would be more afraid of kennel cough. He doesn't need treatment for it, but it's doxycycline. It's like less than $5 you can get at Walmart or something after you go to the event. So that's going to be the next thing you can cover. But when you take him to your vet for the first time, take this to them so that they can copy it in, and they have the region. It's not a whole lot, but you'll have that at least in his record. a shot. So this first year, he's good for a year with his rabies. So because he came in November, that means that going forward, his license and his rabies will always be due in November. Because the license, the dog license is tied to the rabies shot. So he'll need one next year, but then from that point forward, it'll be every 3 years. It's just that first year, it'll be very good for a year. It's the same shot, I don't know. And then this is just simply his one thing.